Mr. Excel Podcast, sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1873, using GetPivotData for an impossible pivot table. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question, sent in by Rekha at YouTube, watched episode 865 that shows how to create a pivot table with year over year. But Rekha needs to create an impossible pivot table with this month from last year, this month from this year, the variance, and then year-to-date for last year, year-to-date for this year, and then the variance urgently, Excel 2010, please. All right, well, now, if Rekha had PowerPivot and had time to study Rob's book on using DAX formulas, you could do this with PowerPivot, but I'm going to assume that there is no PowerPivot available right now. By the way, PowerPivot is absolutely free in Excel 2010. It would absolutely solve this problem, but if you have to do something urgently, you're not going to have time for that. All right, so here's what I did. I created a shell report with customer and these fields we want over here, a parameter with report month that right now has two. I'm going to name that parameter. I'm going to call it RptMo report month. It has to be a single word, no spaces up there, so we have report month. Back to the original data, we're going to add one new column here called year-to-date rev. And we're going to say equal if the month of this date is less than or equal to our report month, then we want the revenue, otherwise we want the zero. Double click to copy that down. All right, now create a pivot table, just a regular pivot table, not a power pivot pivot table. From this data, click OK. Down the side, let's put customer. Across the top, we'll put dates and revenue here in the values area. Now we're going to take these daily dates and we're going to group field and group it up to months and years like that. Let's see, design, report layout, show in tabular form, so we have true headings up there. One funny thing, when we group months and days, they do not give us a year total, and the year total for year to date is what we actually need. So making sure that you're on a year, 2012, come back to field settings, change that to automatic, and that gets us our 2012 total. All right, so we'll add another field here. So we have revenue and year-to-date revenue. This is admittedly an ugly pivot table, and there is no good way to get exactly what Rekha needs. So we're going to switch over to using GetPivotData. Normally, most people hate GetPivotData. If you've turned it off in the past, it will be unchecked there. You want to make sure that that is checkmarked. We're going to come over here to take a look at our sheet. So our customers down the side, that's just going to be a straight copy and paste. So Control C and Alt ESV there. Okay. Now, to build this report, the first two formulas are going to be formulas that we build by pointing into the pivot table. So here I'm looking for AIG February 2012. So I type the equal sign, go click on the pivot table sheet, find AIG, and we're looking for February sum of revenue right there. Now it's an empty cell in this particular case, but that's okay. We have to click on the right cell in order to get our get pivot data formula. And what we see here is that they've hard coded the fact that this is month two, they've hard coded AIG, they've hard coded the year. All right, so we're going to need to change that hard coding to point to our report month field. For AIG, we're going to delete that and click on AIG over in A5. Now, I always want that to point to column A, so I'm going to press F4 one, two, three times to put the dollar sign before the A. And for 2012, I'm going to click on cell B3, and there I want to lock it down to the row, so F4 twice to do that. All right, so we can now copy that formula throughout the pivot table. All right, and we're actually getting February 2012, February 2013. At the bottom, Alt equals to put the grand total in. The variance, Rekha didn't say if it was a variance percentage or a absolute variance. If it was just an absolute variance, then 2013 minus 2012, and copy that down, not as a percentage. I'm assuming it's a percentage though. So 2013 divided by 2012 minus 1 gives us a div by error. So we do if error, and we show a zero when there were no sales, and copy that down. All right, so that formula copies over to G, Now here for the year date, what we have to do is we have to add up the year to date number for all of 2012. So again, an equal sign here, go back to our pivot table, and we are going to find the 2012 sum of year to date revenue. Again, click on the right cell and then come back and examine the get pivot data formula. We have to change the AIG hard coding to point to cell A5. And years to point to E3, and again F4 2 times there. Should be able to copy this throughout. And again at the bottom, Alt equals to put the grand totals in. All right, so we now have the original data. We added one column there, created the world's worst pivot table here. No one will ever have to see this, and then a report that is pulling data from the pivot table to get those columns that we're looking for that report. Again, this would have been possible using the free PowerPivot add-in, but you'd have to use namesets and be able to create a couple of DAX measures using time intelligence functions, and that would have involved a calendar table, and it sounds like this report has to be done this morning, so I'm going with these convoluted set of steps. At least you'll have it done in 10 minutes. Well, I want to thank Rekha for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.